face of shipping. Today we're in Miami, and we're speaking with Captain Buscman. Captain Buscman, thank you for making time to speak to the seafarers today. I know your schedule is very intense. Can you tell the seafarers a little bit about your career at sea?
Well, I'm a 1984 graduate of the United States Coast Guard Academy, so during my time there was my first introduction, and I had a number of training cruises during the summers. That was my introduction. And then after graduation, I've had three different float tours on the West Coast on one of our 378-foot cutters. I've been on the East Coast, stationed on a 270-foot medium endurance cutter out of Boston, and I command a patrol boat out of Puerto Rico.
How has your time at sea helped you to achieve the responsible positions you've had ashore? You were captain of the port of Key West, now chief of staff of the entire operation here in the 7th District.
I have learned a lot that has helped me not only in my Coast Guard career, but in my life. From a Coast Guard career standpoint, I learned so much. First off, I learned about the environment and the seagoing environment, which is really, really a unique environment, operating in the Bering Sea in the winter, operating in the North Atlantic in the wintertime, and the types of weather conditions you see there, some of the icing conditions, some of the severe weather conditions you see down in Puerto Rico, where you're in the middle of hurricane season or hurricane country. You really learn about the sea and some of the unique challenges you face when you're on a ship in that type of environment. And you really need to respect the environment. You need to learn that the sea is a very, very challenging environment. And as a result of that, if you're in a seagoing profession, it tells you that you really need to pay attention to things like your training. You need to pay attention to the condition of your ship and to make sure everything is in absolutely perfect condition, because that environment is very unforgiving. And it also teaches you a lot about teamwork and how to work together as a team. And if you don't do that, it can be a very, very unsafe situation.
Very topical subjects this year is the revision of STCW, or the IMO's guidelines for training, and also, of course, the introduction of the ILO's Maritime Labor Convention. So this has been nominated as the Year of the Seafarer. Mm. And the training, of course, is very important, as is mentoring when you talked about teamwork. Are there any special initiatives that you'd like to share with the seafarers about what's going on with the Coast Guard and or the 7th District, very large area of the 7th District?
No specific initiatives. I just do want to talk about training and teamwork and what we talked about earlier about what I learned going to sea. And I remember one of the stark realities I learned early on in one of my early training cruises when I was just a cadet. I remember crossing the Atlantic Ocean and we had a fire on board the ship. And I remember that feeling, what it was like hearing that alarm, not a training alarm, a real alarm for a fire, and what that felt like. And the fact that you didn't pick up the phone and call 911 and call the fire department. The fire department was on board your ship. It was you and it was your crew and it was your fellow crew members. And you really had to pull together and work as a team to deal with that emergency, because there wasn't help for probably days. Could someone come to help you? So that just reinforced the notion of teamwork. It also reinforced the notion of training, because you can't succeed in that type of situation and keep everyone safe, yourself and your shipmates safe, if you haven't trained extremely well to handle that emergency and trained to work as a team and look out for each other when you're at sea.
So. Well, that's very valuable advice from someone who's faced it firsthand, and I'm sure that had a formulating effect on your career going forward in terms of taking your training very seriously. And the seafarers do have some excellent options for training, and that's constantly being updated and many opportunities for them to do the training. I know your schedule is very tight and you have to move off to some important meetings. Are there any other advice you'd like to offer the seafarers now, or is anything on the 7th District that we can provide them as an attachment to this with some information about Coast Guard affairs?
No, I just say that I think the Coast Guard has a number of roles that impact seafarers. First off, we regulate them in terms of ship standards. We regulate them in terms of ship movements in our ports. We regulate them in terms of licenses. We provide services such as search and rescue at sea, law enforcement at sea, when there's a problem at sea. The Coast Guard is the first one you call here in the U.S. and off our shores. My advice is to work with the Coast Guard, whatever capacity you are. We work really, really hard. We understand the burden of regulations and how they can have a burden on industry and seafarers. And we work really, really hard to have a good relationship with the industry, because I think it's in both our interests to communicate with each other effectively and to have a great working relationship, and it serves both our interests positively.
So. Well, there's an important message from one seafarer to another. Thank you for making time from your schedule, and we wish the seafarers safe sailing, and hopefully they'll get to meet you and many of your colleagues when they come to the 7th District.
Thank you. Okay.